Okay, I thought I'd show my Eaton shifter mod for my Logitech G27. It's a real shift knob off of eBay. I basically went inside and put in reed switches and magnets. So basically these activate the reed switches when you move the splitter and the range. And then it's connected directly to two of the existing buttons on the Logitech shifter, so it doesn't use an external board or anything like that. We're in my 389, got a pretty big trailer. So I'm just going to be taking off out of Carlisle in Fairbanks, Alaska, and we'll just cruise around town a little, kind of show how it works. That one. And I am using a 18-speed gearbox. Guess I can demonstrate by just kind of going through all the gears at the bottom here. So kind of one of the limitations of American Truck Sim and how the shifting works, if let's say you were in 6 high and you wanted to go to 7 low, so you bring your splitter back, if you let off the throttle, it immediately downshifts. In real life it doesn't downshift instantly like that. So it immediately downshifts. So you get that jump in your RPM before you get to move the lever. So the one way I've found to get around that is, okay, so we'll bring the button back. So we'll pre-select low. And then we'll bring the shifter out just a second before we let off the throttle. And that prevents that jump in the RPM from the instant downshift, if that makes sense. And we can do the same thing for a downshift. See, I pre-selected high before going down to 6 and pulled the lever out slightly before letting off the throttle. So again, pull the lever out slightly before I take my foot off the throttle. Otherwise, again, if you don't, if you take your foot off the throttle, we'll get a bump. Sorry. We're in high. We'll get a bump before you move the lever. And it's just not correct, so. This map has a bit of a problem. It's got stop signs right after the turns on this road, so the AI traffic stops when it's trying to turn. If you're not paying attention, you'll run right into them. So yeah, just that one little quirk of having to pull it out of gear slightly before you let off the throttle is something you kind of have to get used to. But once you're used to it, you don't even really notice that you're doing it. missed that. Thanks for watching.